load of rubbish in it.
Do you restore it yourself or you get it like that?
No, I bought it as you see it.
Oh, okay.
But to my knowledge, it's all original. It's never been welded as far as I can see.
Oh, right, yeah.
I've had it about 7 or 8 years, I suppose. As you see, the seats are tatty and the door cards, but and I mean, I've got another one at home. I've got a two-seater sports at home. I had it here last year, the red one. Oh, it's a 7 again. But when I saw this, the colour said, yeah. And that's my wife just got walked across there. And when we went to see it, as we drove down this chap's drive and it was parked in front of his garage, she said, we're going to have that.
All right, yeah.
Normally I have to try and persuade her, but she said, no, that wasn't going
to happen. She likes it, yeah.
I mean, she hates it now because it doesn't stop.
Well,
it doesn't go very fast either.
No.
But my little sports, I mean, that's much better. But I can only drive one at a time.
Yeah.
So we campaigned this one this year, there'll be the red one next year, and so on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what you do, like, about 40, can it do about 40 mile an hour, something like that?
It struggles.
It struggles at 40, yeah. Oh.
Yeah, it will do just.
Yeah.
But they're all wire brakes, you see, and they don't stop. Tiny little drums, look at them. They,
yeah.
You know.
Mm.
I know when I was when I first started driving, well, motorcycles, the local garage, I used to go up for the MOTs and that. And they had, the chap was MOTing one, and I was seven, this is back in the early 60s, 1962, something like that. And he said, really, in truth, that you shouldn't pass the MOT.
Right.
I mean, then, that time, it was the old Tapley meter, and, you know, it wasn't a rolling road.
Oh, yeah,
A Tapley meter on the floor.
Yeah, that's it.
And he said, when these were brand new, when they came out of the factory, they wouldn't pass that current MOT.
Oh, well, I didn't have MOTs in them days, did I?
No.
Yeah,
but of course, it's okay if you drive it at 30 miles an hour and everybody else does the same, which is what, when they came out, that's what it was like.
Yeah.
But now, people see you coming down the road and think, of course, I don't want to get stuck behind that old car. They pull out in front of you quickly.
That's it, yeah.
They don't realise you can't stop. In fact, this is a 1933. They started making them in 1922. It was a centenary last year. And up until from 1922 to 1930, the brakes weren't coupled. The foot brake worked the back and the handbrake worked the front.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. And I belong to a club and I know people own early uncoupled brakes. And I said, well, that must be wicked. He said, no, you look at the foot brake and you look at the handbrake, look at the leverage you can get on that, you know. And if you have to do an emergency stop, even in this, it's both, foot brake and handbrake, because the handbrake works on all four wheels on this one.
All right, yeah.
That's the only really thing that's really efficient on them is the handbrake. Nipper, mum and dad had one of these.
That's it, yeah.
And they used to, we used to go right in at Devon with the suitcases and everything, and me and my brother in the back. But I mean, this is the only luggage capacity. It's this.
Oh, yeah.
And they used to stack the suitcases on there. I'm just going to put a picnic basket on it.
Yeah, it's clever, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah. But a good fun. I mean, and the beauty of it is, I mean, I think I did my first steam rally with an old vehicle in 1972. And these were always popular because you can get every nut and bolt for them. You can get everything for them.
You still get all the bits for
them? Oh, everything. They remake them. There's so.
Oh, they? Yeah.
We were at the centenary rally last year at Morton and the Marsh in Gloucestershire at the Fire Service Training College. And it wasn't a rally for the public, it was only for members, club members, Austin 7 owners and club members.
Hmm.
And they had 1,450 Austin 7s there.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I took my little sports. Yeah, we got a motorhome up in the field.
Yeah.
Tucked on a trailer. But I only live about 12 miles away from here. Mm. Place called Liverpool.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Ooh. But it seems to be the norm now. There seems to be a competition between having the rustiest tractor. I think he's winning the one in front.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, well. Very nice. Got this rare Trojan here, 1924. It's a square four, but it's a two stroke. Two speed. You say 40 miles per gallon, 40 miles an hour. And the engine is under the floorboards down here. Yeah, it's an epicyclic gearbox, a clutch here. It's like bands, like a band brake almost, doesn't it? On there. And it's got the conrods here that are joined. I think they give a little bit of flex when they move. This is a square four, it just has the two spark plugs, two cylinders go into one combustion chamber. Not in 21 Humber. Use the dynamotor, combined starting and charging system, wasn't it? We've got magneto ignition. Yeah, another Fiat 500.
Belongs to our son, and he's just gone off. He's been up here.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Because he thought we might like to have a look. But yes, he's had it. How long has he had it? About 20 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Cool. It's a 1964.
Yeah.
That's about all I can tell you.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Yeah.
He went to work in Italy for 6 months, stayed 6.5 years, came back to the Fiat 500 and all right.
All right. Yeah. 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 Very nice. Right-hand drive as well. Don't really see many right-hand drives ones, you know, still going really. Yeah. Rotted away, you know, yeah. Most of them. But,
yeah. Especially if you bought it initially.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Quite old bed, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. Very nice, good to see it. Right, we're carrying down the line here. Ford Escorts, Triumph Spitfire, Triumph Stags. Is this Triumph Dolomite or Toledo? Toledo. Austin. Sunbeam Rapier. Rolls Royce here. A little midget, wire wheels on it. I've got another frog eye sprite here. Don't have any door locks on them, that's the only thing about these. Got a little mini moke. Rost in A30, is it A35? Rost in camper. Down the pull down gears. Nearly 3,000. I think they use the same engine. I think MGC use the same engine, don't they? The C series engine. Mini Morris Minor. Morris 8. That's an MG. Not a late MG, is it? But not an early one. Modern classic, I suppose you could say, isn't it? MGB. V8.
You keep saying, oh, don't you love me? I think,
another Austin A30, A35. We've got here. Another Morris. Austin. $19.90 looks like. Lotus. Another Austin. Another Ford here. I've got MGC GT. Wolseley. It's quite a nice looking Morris. Morris Oxford. It's quite an early Morris Minor, this one. It's a low light one. Headlights should still be up there, but down there. So it's quite an early one. This is split screen as well. Pontiac Chief. Early on, this is 1920s, I suppose, I should think. Nearly 3,000. Totally restored by the looks of things, look at the interior on that. Absolutely immaculate that is. Old Jag. couple of ferrets here. So this one here. The Rolls Royce engine. 5-speed gearbox, 60 mile an hour. I think they can go as fast in reverse as they can in forward. Do 9 miles to a gallon. Fuel capacity 21 gallons.
That is an original magazine.
Wow.
And it goes in.
It's okay.
Cops and dry fires.
Can I cook it and dry fire because it's a dunnet?
I've got that online.